Millions of people viewed our 10-part YouTube series, Building My Dream Home, where we followed Zach every step of the way from planning and designing his dream home. Today, we're gonna take a more in-depth look at those details and discuss how you can make it your dream home. Hi, my name is Justin Jankowski with Golden Eagle Log & Timber Homes. I'm one of the sales advisors here at Golden Eagle. I'm sitting here today with my colleague, John Wendt, one of the other sales advisors here, and we're gonna talk about the ever popular Timber Ranch 2286. John, I know I receive calls daily about this home, and I'm sure you do too. You know, what are some of the things that that you hear from customers or calls coming in?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, like you mentioned, that Building My Dream Home series was huge. If people haven't seen it, they should definitely go check that out. Awesome video series. First thing I think everybody loves is just that curb appeal of that home, right? That big 12-inch double hand-hewn siding. I personally think on this home, we did an awesome job creating multiple textures. I think I've heard you tell your customers too, you know, try to get multiple textures and colors on the outside.
For sure. Yeah, the stone, the horizontal wood, the shakes up in the gable, that's awesome. If you can change up the direction of those sidings, those exterior facades, it looks awesome. It really does. And another way to break it up too is above that garage door. You see that awning right there with the steel accent roof?
Yeah.
I mean, man, that could be added anywhere, not just on a garage. I think there's one on the backside as well.
Yep.
So really anywhere you have a gable and you want to break some of that big expanse of siding up on any wall, that's a great way to do it.
Absolutely. And it's really not that big of an impact of price either for people, you know, when you add those little accents like that. So that's a great feature, I think, as well. Other things, you know, those timber trusses. He did the Arch Queen truss up in the gable there and extended the roof line there.
Yeah, the extended ridge there. That's awesome. I mean, it's a great way to break up that line, that straight line fascia. Simple, again, like you said, just to extend that out an extra foot, bring it down, match it where, you know, where the trusses hit the soffit. That's a great way to end it, to break it. And, you know, in the trusses too, you know, those are pretty ornate trusses. You know, being that they're non-structural, you can make those less ornate if you want. If you want to simplify them a little bit, you know, very easily done.
I'm sure you've gotten a ton of calls too, you know, with people call up and they love this house and just want to, you know, maybe it's a little more than they wanted to spend or something. So they ask, you know, a lot of times, what are some ways I can keep this feel of this home, but come in at a little bit, you know, more affordable budget? If you look at the bottom of our page, we detail out how we started this home with a Clearwater floor plan and some of the things that we did to it to get to the point where it was the ultra custom timber specs. We have an excellent 8-inch siding that's a little thinner, not quite as tall as like what Zach used on his home here, that still gives you that rugged hand-hewn look, just at a little bit more of an affordable price, still using that vertical corner. I mean, you could achieve a really nice look home. So I encourage people, when you do check out this house, you know, you see it, you note everything you love about it, give us a call, and we can discuss kind of where people want to be budget-wise and the direction they want to go with that home, right?
I mean, this home, when you're looking at this home, you know, there's a lot of things that are going to go into the home that are going to affect price. But, you know, when we took a step back and put Zach's pricing together, I think it's going to come right in around that 950 mark. You know, can certainly go up or down there, just depending on where you are going to be in the country. And, you know, like you said, what specs you want in that home. We got a lot of different package specs. And really, those package specs are just starting points for clients. Nobody takes one of those specific package specifications and builds that exact home. They're mixing and matching and tweaking it until they get it just right. You know, that's the reason most people are building new, is they want to make it their own. You know,
yep.
They don't want a home that was built for the previous homeowner. They want it to, you know, fit their specific lifestyle and how they're going to intend to use a home, whether it's a first or a second home, or whether kids are close or they're far away and they need the extra space. So definitely one of the benefits of building a new home.
I just actually had a customer basically copy this floor plan, but he wanted to make it just a tad bit bigger. So we stretched out that center section of the home a little bit.
Yeah.
As a result, he took that staircase, moved it off to the sidewall. That's a pretty common thing.
That's what I was just gonna say. Sorry not to interrupt, but that staircase is probably the number one thing people are looking to maybe move out of the center of that home and just kind of open it up. While some people still like it, it kind of gives them some separation between the kitchen and dining and great room. But that's maybe one of the things, one of the top things I see people doing, trying to move that. The sidewall is a great idea, or tucking it maybe where the pet room is, I've done, or in that laundry mudroom area. There's a lot of room in there, you know, that you could stick that staircase, but you know, to each his own for sure.
Another neat thing my customer did, and I know I talked to somebody else here, and they said they had a customer also do, because you have that half bath already there in the entry area for guests. Yeah. The specific customer I was working with had two children that were going to use bedroom 2 and 3. He stretched that side out a little bit, made it a little bigger, and then did it an actual Jack and Jill bathroom over there. So it wasn't just like a common bathroom to guests. You know, the kids had their own little bathroom over there. And when you do have company, you still have the half bath right there. So it was, you know, kind of closed it off, but it turned out really nice, I thought.
Yeah, that's funny you say that, because the customer in Lower Michigan too, he did that exact same thing. And then he added 2 feet to that wing of the home, and it gave him that Jack and Jill bathroom. Sure. Yeah, that's awesome. I mean, the plan changes, customizing that home, very easily done with our in-house design staff. Right now we have 6 guys in there that design the homes from preliminary stage all the way to final construction documents. So they're keeping up on code requirements throughout the country. You know, a lot of intel coming out of that room for sure. But it's so nice to have those guys right there in the next room. If there's any question about the design, if it can or can't be done, you know, height restrictions or code requirements, you know, they're easily grabbed into a phone conversation, a Zoom meeting, or even an in-person meeting at this point. So, definitely a benefit having those guys right here, no doubt.
So moving to the back of the house, I guess we kind of touched on the front there. One thing I like about the back and a lot of customers kind of coming on is that railing that he used back there. He did a nice job, I feel, mixing, you know, the metal with the timber, still keeping some timber feel to the newel post out there, but still kind of gave it, you know, with some metal accent. I got a lot of customers that love that look.
That industrial look, and mixing that black industrial, you know, the gas piping handrail you'll see on the inside going down to the stairs. And really, you know, like you said, it's going to reduce maintenance, but it also gives you, I think, a clearer view, you know, out that backside. Sure. So if you have, if you have a view of a lake, river, you know, woods, whatever it may be, I think you capture more of that view with that style of railing too.
Yep. Now we still have that awesome timber edge, that worn timber edge rail too, that a lot of customers love. So, I mean, a lot of people just keep all wood back there too. Don't think you have to go with metal, but
right. He did that in the front.
Options. Yeah, he kept the wood in the front too. So
it mixed well.
So many
it really
options.
Blended well. Yeah.
Sure.
And also, you know, what we did on one of the other homes, that Timberlake home, is dropping the center portion of that deck. You know, so if you're high up on the hill, you know, and there's a steep slope, maybe going down to the lake or the river, dropping that deck will help you capture that view of the lake a little better. Mm-hmm. Especially if you're perched up a little bit there.
Now, some people, I think, have a hard time visualizing. I mean, you know, if they're not used to drawing plans and stuff. The customer, a couple of customers I sold this home to, I had one do it as just a ranch on a standard basement.
Yeah.
Another customer actually did a walkout basement. So I don't know if you've had any do a walkout on this home, but this home easily suits a walkout basement too, right underneath that deck, you know. It turned out really nice looking. So
that's a good point to bring up, because some people may look at a plan and see that it doesn't have that walkout. I'm like, I need a walkout, and maybe move on to a different plan. Walkout can easily be added to any plan. Pop some egress windows in there, some patio doors, get some natural light down there, and add some serious square footage to that home. That lower level or basement square footage will be the most inexpensive square footage you ever add in that house. So,
correct.
And I think in this home, we were just talking about it, well, you can add another almost, 1,700 square feet to this floor plan?
1,765 square feet.
Yeah, so this home becomes almost 4,000 square feet when it's all said and done by doing that.
Yep. Another neat thing I've seen people do, add porches off the bedroom wings, if you will. Do like a nice covered porch off the master and one off the bedroom 2 area.
There you go.
You know, just if you want like that covered grill porch. Nice little place to tuck it off over that bedroom. Just some thoughts.
Just a couple other things on the outside, then maybe we'll jump to the inside, but the slope soffits on there, you know, it doesn't have to be a horizontal soffit. So just another little detail that we've done recently on some of our homes. But walking right into the inside of this particular plan, you're gonna be greeted by those timber trusses, you know, right that front door. It's like, boom, right when you walk in, kitchen, dining, great room. I mean, you see the really meat potatoes of that home right from the front door. The wood ceilings throughout, that carved nickel space, so popular.
That I think that's what everybody gravitates to, honestly, yeah. is the colors that were used in this home, mm-hmm. I think complemented one another really well. Some people love it, you know, other people have other taste, and we have a wide variety of stain colors people can go with for sure. Oh. But
People always ask, like, is the wood always that color? I'm like, no, that's just the stain color that you select, and that's just the color that client decided to go with. So,
yeah. No, speaking of, I guess as long as we're talking about the ceiling, great time to point out maybe a difference between some customers might look at our website and they see this one's the UCT, which would be the Ultra Custom Timber Specs. We also have this floor plan as the BR, which is going to be a little bit of tweaks to it, but it's been priced out as the exposed beam or a log package specs, right? We're kind of circling back to what we talked about just a little bit ago with those trusses outside. On the Ultra Custom Timber, we've got this awesome carved nickel space, tongue and groove up there, where on the exposed beam, we're going to have more of our traditional Ponderosa pine, number two Ponderosa pine tongue and groove up there, which can come pre-finished. We've got a pre-finished color. It's very close to this one, but you don't get that real rustic look to it that is kind of the driving behind his ceiling. So that would just be one thing when people are looking at it and saying, what's the difference between these packages? That's kind of one thing I point out right away.
Yeah.
This has got that awesome hand scraped look to the ceiling where the exposed beam is at standard. But I do think you told me one time somebody did our hand hewn.
I was going to say that.
Groove, right?
I had a customer that did our standard TNG hand hewn finishing, which saved them, which is probably right in between the cost of our standard TNG and this carved nickel space. Probably couldn't tell the difference really between that hand hewn TNG and this carved nickel space. It looks awesome. They stained it almost exactly the same color, and it turned out sharp. If you are looking to reduce some of the costs in this plan, you can not vault the ceilings and maybe the wings of the home. We call the wings of the home the bedroom 2 and 3 and the master bedroom. That's a good way to save some cost.
You
lose those lofts, but it's a good way to do it.
Go to more of like a common truss with just a flat ceiling in there, you're saying? Yeah, yep. Yeah,
for sure.
And if you still want a little bit taller ceiling, you can still bump it up to a 9-foot wall height. Zach's house here, we did 10, I believe it was, right?
In the center section.
Nine in the wings, as you call it. You can go to a flat ceiling, but still maybe keep it at a 9-foot wall height, so you still get a little bit taller ceiling in there. That's always an option too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when going to taller wall heights, really the thing that's going to add the most expense is going to be, raising those window heights. Now typically windows get a foot taller, and then some clients will increase the interior door height as well. So that's probably where you see the most significant cost when going to taller walls.
It's up to the customer what they want to do, that's for sure.
Yeah, I mean, he went really above and beyond with those interior doors. The interior doors match the cabinetry in that home. I mean, our kitchen design staff is awesome. I mean, if you look at that kitchen, every little detail was thought about, where the crown molding was going to come in and hit the walls, raising cabinetry in the corners, increasing the depth. Those are really easy ways to add a lot of interest to that kitchen, and not a lot of cost really when it comes down to it.
I personally like how he integrated some glass panels in there too. Mm-hmm. Just kind of dress it up a little bit, add a little character in there. And everybody comments on that stone range hood,
hood, yeah.
That's something we can do too,
For sure. I mean, with cultured or manufactured stone, it's really easy to do that. We basically reinforce our engineering staff. Reinforce the roof trusses and the hood there to hold the weight of that stone, and then banding it with that hand hewn heavy 4x trim there really sets it off. And really, I guess it doesn't have to be stone on that hood. I've had clients do tongue and groove, reclaim product there. So really, that hood that exhausts the moisture from your cooking it's really just a wrapping for that. So you can put whatever finish you want on there. So, in the island, you can see they did two different colors of cabinetry in that kitchen. The kitchen, the island, is a little bit darker. So that's very popular. I've even seen clients do base cabinets different color than the uppers.
Sure.
You know, some other features in there, the little pop-up outlet that, that you may see in some of the videos. You know, if you need to plug a phone in or, you know, a crock pot or a Nesco or something, doesn't have to dangle over the side of the island there and, you know, somebody catch it on their pants or something. You know, it's a nice little feature there. Yeah, it's unbelievable. That's why we have a team dedicated just for that, that design of the home. And really, it's not limited to kitchen cabinetry. I mean, we use it in just about every room of the house. You can see in the pantry, there's cabinetry. In the mudroom, laundry room, bathrooms, obviously. You know, and then talking about bedrooms, you know, those ultra custom timber packages, we offer the closet organizing systems as well.
Yep, put shelving right in there, built-ins and stuff. So as long as we're in the bedrooms, you know, some of the things that obviously people have seen in the video series is he does have the vaulted ceilings in the bedrooms. He decided to put the lofts up there. Don't have to do that. You could extend that wall all the way up, have it meet the ceiling. I've had a customer actually center vault the master, so it vaulted up from wall, you know, the two side walls instead of just one vault direction. I've seen people do that, but you know, those bedrooms, we got that awesome band board in there that we carried in, some cool timber beams going up the ceilings there.
Yeah.
Nice features.
And I think that's one of the benefits of, you know, of a single story at home is you can do this kind of cool little lofted stuff or change ceiling heights very easily or vaulted ceilings.
Another thing I love about when you look at like the master bedroom, the use of the casement window there. So you don't have that like a double hung window. You have that bar in the middle. Some people don't like that. Going to that casement window, just that full glass, you know, clear view, ton of natural light comes into that house by doing that.
For sure. I mean, we were just working with a client this week, Tim and I in the engineering department, they want to maximize their glass. So we're getting them 83 inches tall by 132 inch wide pane, and had to be tempered and all that. But, you know, so it's pretty amazing. Every year, you know, the products get a little bit better and easier to work with. So.
Not to get off topic of this house, but I think that is one of the most common things customers ask me, I'm sure you get it too, is how do I get more windows? How do I get more glass?
Right,
you know,
yeah.
People are, they're building these homes and, you know, a lot of times you got that $1 million view, that lake view, that mountain view, you know, so they see a house and, oh, I just love the windows on this house. We can put windows in any home on any different floor plan. Keep that in mind too, you know. We utilized every kind of door style.
I know. On this house. I'm looking at a pocket door in the master bath, and there was a split sliding barn door going into the laundry room. You're right. He really kind of, and then that pantry, he's got those like saloon doors, you know, that swing both ways. Yeah. That's kind of cool. So yeah, I think he's got just about every option for interior doors that you could in this house. And I'm looking at the master bath, man, that shower is awesome. I mean, one of the things that pops out to me is no door. You know, one less thing to clean.
Zero entry.
Yeah.
Everybody's talking at zero entry, whether it's in the shower or from the garage. Very popular now. Everybody's talking at wider doors. You know, as long as we're on there. Another thing I really like and I get a lot of feedback on is the flow from the laundry area to the master closet, kind of.
Oh, yeah.
You know, just that ability to just kind of flow when you're doing laundry and stuff is...
That's awesome.
People don't think of those little things, but, you know, us as salespeople will try to point stuff out like that to you. You know, do you want to carry your clothes all the way around? Or
all the way, right?
We put a little door here and you got... A lot less steps, that's for sure.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, that master bath, some of the other things I see and I notice in there that clients point out is the wall-to-wall mirror there. It's huge. Got to be at least 8x4. You know, that's about a sheet of plywood right there. You know, a mirror that big. You know, it just makes that room feel even larger than it is, you know, having that mirror there. And then the faucets right below the mirror that are actually mounted on the wall. It's going to make it easier to clean that countertop, that's for sure. And moving across the home to the kids' bedroom on the other side, and that bath in between the two. I really like that ceiling, the timber joists up there and the 2x6 decking. That's the actual ceiling support there. And then it also branches out into the bedrooms, and that's the flooring and support for those loft spaces as well. I like how he kept the theme of the industrial look with the ladders and the railing. Boy, that's cool. I mean, you can see every little detail was thought about, even in the fan, you know, matches that industrial look that he kept throughout the house.
For sure.
And the little door in between those loft spaces again, you know, they can sneak back and forth between the two bedrooms. I don't know if that's good or bad for the kids' bedroom, but I know my kids love that idea when we looked at it.
He incorporated more drywall finish in there. A lot of people think, you know, drywall is just going to be boring, but he did a really good job with the texturing of it. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, you can really, nowadays with what you can do with even just simple drywall, to bring in some rustic feel still is a good use. Let's pretend like I'm a customer there, Justin. I love this home. You sold me on it. What's my next step? What do I do?
Well, yeah, I mean, the next step would be moving into a design service. You know, if the ballpark prices that we've given you fit within the budget you want to maintain, then yeah, let's move into a design service, a plan service. We're actually going to draw that custom home plan for you. And, you know, we're going to make any changes that you want to that home. We're going to draw it specifically to your location as well. So these aren't generic plans. These are going to be the plans that you're going to go in and pull permits with. So that's the next step, usually step two of our typical process. And we'll go through a whole revision process. And that could be done through emails, phone calls, in person. You know, we're doing a lot of Zoom meetings now. So we can handle a lot of that design work over the phone. So when you make your first visit, if it is your first visit, you know, you can finalize that design and do your final selections at that same time. So
yeah, I mean, if people are excited, I know a lot of people call up and love this house. We get calls all the time. So if they've looked it over and they're excited and want to talk that next step, I definitely say give Justin, me, Jan, Jeff, you know, anyone here at Golden Eagle a call. And let's talk about that next step and see how we can make that dream come true for them, right?
For sure. Look forward to doing it.